Recently, the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, 5th edition, has changed the name Seasonal Affective Disorder, or SAD, to Depressive Disorder with Seasonal Pattern. The new name isn't as catchy as SAD, or SAD, but it does describe the condition more precisely. That's because Depressive Disorder with Seasonal Pattern is not really a distinct disease, but rather depression that worsens at the same time each year, usually in late fall and winter. So first, let's review depression. Depression, or major depression, is a serious condition where someone's life isn't enjoyable and it interferes with their day-to-day life, like working, studying, eating, and sleeping. The causes of depression aren't fully known, but it's thought to involve a deficiency of monoamine neurotransmitters in the brain, like dopamine, norepinephrine, and especially serotonin. In depressive disorder with seasonal pattern, there's a strong relationship with the circadian rhythm, which is an internal clock that keeps your body in tune with the rising and setting of the sun. At the base of the brain is a region called the hypothalamus, and within it are a group of neurons located in a specific spot called the suprachiasmatic nucleus, or SCN. The neurons in the suprachiasmatic nucleus get information about light from the optic nerve and use that information to run the circadian rhythm. The suprachiasmatic nucleus relays that information to the pineal gland, a tiny cone-shaped structure near the hypothalamus. And when it's dark out, the pineal gland releases the hormone melatonin, which is chemically related to serotonin. Melatonin lowers your heart rate and body temperature, which helps you to go to sleep. When it's light outside, the pineal gland stops releasing melatonin, and that has the opposite effect, raising your heart rate and body temperature, and that keeps you awake. A risk factor for developing depressive disorder with seasonal pattern is having something called a sleep phase delay, which is when a person makes too little melatonin at night. This can be due to things like decreased sensitivity to changes in light, problems with the communication between the retina and the hypothalamus, and even external sources of light, like late-night computer use. A sleep phase delay can result in a person's internal clock having more than the standard 24 to 25 hours in a day, which might sound awesome, but actually, it means a person may not be able to sleep until at least 18 hours after they woke up that day. Day after day, that quickly becomes exhausting. It can be hard for anyone to adjust to the late sunrises and early sunsets of winter, especially those who live in higher latitudes. But for those with disordered circadian rhythm, the shorter days seem to somehow interfere with monoamine production, causing the person to become depressed. Another mechanism that might be involved relates to vitamin D, which is largely obtained in a reaction that relies on sunlight. Vitamin D is involved in the synthesis of serotonin and dopamine in the brain, and if someone is already deficient in vitamin D, decreased sunlight, and therefore decreased synthesis of monoamines, might push them into depression. Both the sleep phase delay and the vitamin D deficiency ideas hold promise, but they don't yet explain those few people who get depressive disorder with seasonal pattern in the summer. Symptoms of depressive disorder with seasonal pattern are similar to those of depression, and include intense feelings of worthlessness or guilt, and a lack of enjoyment in activities that they took pleasure in during other times of the year. They may find it hard to concentrate, and in severe cases, have thoughts of death or suicide. So, when it comes to diagnosis, for the depression to be truly seasonal, it must occur in the same season each year for at least 2 years in a row. And the symptoms must diminish or disappear with the new season. It's also important not to confuse seasonally triggered depression with depression caused by recurring psychological or social stressors, like having job pressures or living alone during certain months of the year. Treatment of depressive disorder with seasonal pattern usually includes light therapy, medication, and psychotherapy. In light therapy, a person sits close to an intensely bright light for 30 to 90 minutes every morning. Unlike the light bulbs you'd normally use around your house, light therapy boxes have wavelengths of light that allow the skin to produce vitamin D. Antidepressants can also be helpful. For example, Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors can increase serotonin levels, and bupropion can increase norepinephrine and dopamine levels. Finally, cognitive behavioural therapy can be particularly useful in helping people to identify and manage their feelings. Alright, as a quick recap, seasonal affective disorder, otherwise known as depressive disorder with seasonal pattern, is a depression that recurs in the same season for at least 2 years in a row, and the symptoms must diminish or disappear with the new season. It usually occurs in the late fall and winter months, and may be related to dysregulated circadian rhythm or vitamin D deficiency. Hi everyone, Sarah here. Thanks for watching that video on seasonal affective disorder, or if we're being strict, depressive disorder with seasonal pattern, according to the DSM-5. Anyway, I feel like it's come at a good time of year. It's getting cold. I've got my hat, my coat, my bright lamp to try and get some vitamin D in this grill. Probably not the right wavelength, but I've got the right idea. Anyway, great script was written by Simone Taylor, edited by Rishi Desai. I did the illustration and the voiceover, and the whole thing was edited by Sam Gillespie. If you liked that video and you like the other videos that are on the Osmosis channel, then you should head over to osmosis.org, where there are tons more videos that we don't actually release on YouTube. So it's a great place to access loads of learning resources for medicine. Highly recommend that, and I look forward to making the next video. See you later.